special about India for you? Because I know from talking to you before, it seems a special place for you.
It's absolutely vibrant. People are passionate about learning in India. You know, it's not surprising that they are emerging as such a leader in the world. The very nice thing from a trainer's point of view is that for them, trainers and teachers are on a par with, if not above, God. So they would never argue with a teacher. They'll never say, like, prove it to them. They will question, you know, and absolutely want to understand. The Indians are horrified the way some of the people from the rest of the world will go, do you really mean that? You know, are you really sure about that? Because they would never do that. So the respect they have for teachers is fantastic. But it absolutely supports their learning because, you know, instead of spending time questioning something, they learn it and then they decide how to use it. And it's a real reminder of what life's about. You know, when we're there, we're living in amongst people who are living with no running water. They go to a stand pipe in the road. They cook on like 2-ring gas rings. They fish for their food in the daytime. And you just think, you know, all the things that we have in our lives, you know, all the commodities and so on. And it's a very spiritual place as well. So it's a real kind of bring you down to earth. Anyways.
Yeah, my passion is to train South Africa beginning next year. Hopefully February. That's my goal.
Oh, wow.
So, yeah, similar reasons. And because, similar to India, there's such a huge change in terms of them emerging as leaders in the world. So, yeah.
I've got somebody from South Africa coming to India, actually, and they're involved with doing training for women who've been repressed in South Africa.
Yeah. There's a lot happening there at the moment in training, so it's an interesting place to look at.
Yes, and I just think where there's that passion, that desire to learn, and people, you know, eager for the learning. I mean, in India, they have a lot of this way of thinking. You know, they have an NLP way of thinking in their tradition, so it's not alien by any means. And it's more a case of, like, reconnecting them with that, you know, rather than it's not teaching new, because they have beliefs, you know, beliefs of excellence. We link up with a Swami there, and he says, you know, you're coming here calling this NLP, and we have this in our Indian, we've had all these principles, our Indian culture, a tradition of centuries.
Yeah.
So it's a complete fit.
Yeah, and I think, well, from my experience of South Africa, it's that they're embracing change, whereas I think sometimes in the UK we're resisting it. They just want to make the difference, they want to make that shift, and it's so much easier then, because, as you say, they're wanting to learn.
So, yes, and it's just a delight, isn't it, to be involved in that, be a part of that.
Yeah. Thank you. That's been wonderful. Really enlightening. Thank you.
You're very welcome. Lovely to talk to you again.
Yes,
and all the best. All the best with South Africa too.
Thank you. Yeah. It might mean I can't get to India, but we'll see.
We'll see.
Take care and thank you.
Thanks very much, Heather.